that you are what you're going through, because he's touched back those things that you are touched back. Amen. Now, you would be totally absorbed in his words. But many times, the word of God from the Bible does not have the same impact on most people than if Christ would actually come here and talk to you in person. In other words, many times sometimes I question whether it's even on the level of the word coming from your boss. Many times we don't consider it as what the word of God. We treat it as a what common book. And that's the reason why many times people hear and what? They don't hear. Bible says what? That we need to what? To heed how you hear. That's God's message for you. It's not always what the word is saying, but sometimes what the revelation that's in that word, what, is going to what? Project. So you have to have what? Ears to hear. Let everyone that has what? Ears, let them what? Hear what the what? Spirit of the Lord is saying. So that motivates you to be what? Very, very attentive. Because the scripture says that, amen, the entrance of his word giveth what? Light. It giveth what? Understanding.
Yes.
Amen. Scripture says that the word of God is what? Life to them that what? Find it. Amen. So you be quick to hear, slow to speak, and what? Quick to hear. Many times, amen, the revelation of who we are in Christ will never penetrate our spirits, because many times we don't consider the word of God as being what? Something that God is speaking directly to what? Me. It's food for my soul. Scripture says it's life to them that what? Find it. And it's what? Healing. Everybody just say what? Healing. To what? All of our flesh. Now let me just give you this illustration here. This is really something that I know that is real to me, is that the scripture says that God's word is like a medicine, just like a medicine that we use as a healing agent or a catalyst in the natural. Amen. How many have gone to the doctor and got a prescription, and that prescription placed your body in a, it was a healing agent, because it what? It was a catalyst that enabled your body what? To heal itself. It was a catalyst. It was a healing agent. Now the medicine contains the what? Components in it that had the ability what? To cause your body to what? To recover. Healing wasn't in the medicine. I mean itself. It just placed you. I mean the healing, it was a catalyst. It assisted. Somebody said, doctors contend, but what God is the one that what means.
Yes.
So there's life in the word. See, amen. And the Bible says, but the life in the word, it has to be what? It has to what? It has to get into what? Your spirit. That medicine has to get into your what? Body. It has to be dispensed. So God's word is just like what? Medicine. Because it has to be what? Released into your body in order to do your body some good. And let me tell you, amen, the word, the medicine has no respect of person. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. Is that right? It has no respect of person. Amen. It will heal you. It will help you on the road to recovery if you will what? If you will what? If you would take it. As prescribed, right? If it tells you to take it internally and you start rubbing it on you, it ain't going to work. Is that right? If it tells you to take it before meals and you what? Take it after meal, it's not going to work right. Is that right? All right? If it tells you to take it every day and you take it every other day, or 3 days, or whenever you feel that you want to take it, it's not going to what? See, it doesn't have no respect to a person. blessing, but you got to what? Take it as is what?
Prescribed.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 How many can say amen?
Amen?
All right. Now, another thing about medicine is this. That the medicine that you're taking, it has no respect to a person. Amen. Also, the medicine, amen, is designed to what? Amen. To get results, but most times it's not going to what? Do all that it needs to do what? Overnight. It's just going to take what? Time. So the prescription for the word of God is found in Proverbs 4, verse 20. The prescription for the word of God. Amen. Praise God. It's found in Proverbs 4. Somebody read that for me. Okay.
My son.
Okay, it's on the screen. My son, attend unto my words. Okay, everybody read it? What does it say? All right? Continue. All right. All right. So the medicine, the word is God's healing agent, just as natural medicine is a healing agent or cabinet. Medicine is no respect to person. Medicine must be taken according to direction to be what? Effective. And it takes time for medicine to work. So actually, this is the prescription. Amen, for God's word. That's the reason why the word of God is so important. Because the word of God is designed to what? To bring life. It is designed to bring healing. It's designed to bring direction. It's designed to determine your destiny. It's designed, amen, to bring whatever problem or concern you have. Amen. God always honors his word. And he works through his word. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. I want you to just go to Isaiah 28:16, I believe it is. And we're going to pull that scripture up, Isaiah 28:16. See, God's word is the beginning of building that steadfast faith. Mm-hmm. Isaiah 28:16. Everybody. Okay. Isaiah 28:16. Okay? Therefore, everybody together, thus says the Lord God, behold, I lay in Zion for a what? Okay. See, the word of God is your foundation. Everybody says my foundation. Take somebody that says my foundation. If you want to build a steadfast faith, it's your what?
Foundation.
Say it again. It's my foundation.
Foundation.
All right. Now, the Bible says that the foundation of God stands what? It stands sure. And the Bible says the word of God is a stone. Foundation of stone. A what? Tried. Everybody said tried stone. A precious stone. A sure foundation. He that believeth shall not make what? In other words, you will never have to go running hither and thither looking for something else to hold on to when you build on what? The foundation. Because the foundation of God stands what? Sure. So the reality of God's word, the revelation of God's word, amen, is the first step. You must know that God, in every case, when he's speaking, he is speaking directly to you. So don't apply to nobody else. God is what? Speaking to you. Hallelujah. It's to me. Take it personally. Amen. Take heed how you hear. Take heed what you hear. And the scripture in Proverbs 4 tells you how to take the medicine. Attend to it. Pay attention. Give it what? Time. Glory. Give it
And it says that don't let it depart from your eyes. Keep it in the midst of your heart. And the scripture says it will be what? Life to them that find it. And it will be what? Healing to all of their flesh. How many can say the word is the answer to all of my problems when I get a revelation of the word? When I get a revelation of it, you have to many times work with it before it will what? Begin to what? Become what? Rhema. So you want to master scriptures that's going to build you. You want to master scriptures, I mean, praise God, amen, that's going to what? Give you a greater revelation of God's goodness, God's mercy, God's love, God's compassion, God's willingness, and scriptures that's dealing with God's eager yearning. And above that, amen, all of the scriptures that pertains to God's grace, amen, those are scriptures that places all of God's provisions and blessings in the past tense. He has already done that through his what? Sacrificial word. So grace, amen, is a gift of God and is not of ourselves. Amen. It's a faith. Amen. Praise God. Not of works, lest any man what should boast. Yes. Amen. I got one example I'm going to have to cut off. Okay, I want you to turn to Psalms 105. See, God's word is tried. It will never return void. God's word is tried. It's calculated to give you the results that you need. It's in the word. It's contained in the word. The ability to get results is contained in the word when you take it, when you eat it, when you attend to it. Glory. Psalms 105. Okay, amen. I want you to turn to Psalms 105. And let's look at verse 16. Moreover, he called for famine upon the land. He brake the whole staff of bread. Now, see, God's word is a sure foundation. It will always come to pass. Now, this is speaking about Joseph when he had the dream. God was speaking to Joseph, what? Directly. It was a personal word when he had that dream of those sheaves. How many remember the sheaves? He was binding these sheaves, and his sheaves, what? Stood up, what? Stood upright. How many remember that? And all of his brother's sheaves are what? They stood around. They were bowing, doing obeisance. They were bowing. And this got Joseph's brothers stirred up. He said, is he going to reign over us? All right, so his sheep bowed down. Amen. His sheep stood straight up, and 11 sheaves, amen, representing the 11 brothers, all what? Bowed down as his sheaves was standing up. So he, amen. That shows that, that was showing that one day he was going to reign over them. How many can say amen? All right, then he had another dream. Another dream was that the sun and the moon and the what? Star, 11 stars bowed down to him. So God was getting over to Joseph that one day that the whole family, the mom and the dad and all of the children will have to what? Bow down. This represented the time that famine would come on the land. And this is what we're speaking about in verse 16. He called for a famine upon the land. He brake the whole staff of bread. He sent a man before them, even who? Joseph, who was what? Sold for a servant. See, he had some bad luck, but the Bible says God's word just kept following him. Everywhere he went, everything he touched, down in Egypt at Potiphar's house, he was placed over the whole household of Potiphar. God caused everything that Joseph what? Put his hand to what? Prosper. Amen. For Joseph's sake, God blessed Joseph because his word had already been what? Had already been spoken. And God, it will stand behind his word to what? To perform it. So God's word couldn't fail. Even though when his wife lied on him, he ended up in prison. He was placed in prison, in fetters, in chain. But in prison, the word of God came. Hallelujah. And the word of God came in prison. The Bible says, whose feet they heard, amen, with fetters, he was laid in iron until the time that his word came, the word of the Lord, what? Tried him. The king, what? Sent and loosed him, even the ruler of the people, and let him go free. He made him lord of his house and ruler of all of his substance. Divide his press at his pleasure and teach his senators wisdom. Amen. So God took him from the what? Pit to the pulpit to the highest position in Egypt. And his sons came after he was exalted and what bowed down to him just like God had what revealed to him in that dream. Now, is God's word always reliable?
Yes.
Will it always come to pass?
Yes.
Can we depend on it?
Yes.
Has he ever been unfaithful?
No.
Amen. God will what? Stand behind his word to what? To perform it. Scripture says there hasn't failed what? One word of all of God's good promises.
Amen.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we want to know that God's word will always prevail. Whatever God says you are, hallelujah, he's going to what? Stand behind his word to perform it. Whatever God says, amen, if you are redeemed from the curse of the law, God is going to what? Stand behind that word. If God says he has delivered you from the power of darkness and has translated you into the kingdom of his dear son, amen. He's going to what? Stand behind his word.
Amen.
Touch somebody and say, he's going to stand behind his word. Say, he's going to stand behind his word. Hallelujah. Amen. Whoever God says you are, amen, you are.
Amen.
Whosoever believeth, amen, whosoever is born of God, overcometh the world.
Yes.
For this is the victory. Somebody say, this is the victory.
This is the victory.
Turn around and tell somebody, this is the victory.
My faith in God.
Come on, say, my faith in God. What God has done for me. What God has done for me. He has delivered me. Come on, say it. From the power of darkness. Say it again. He has delivered me. From the power of darkness. And he has what? Translated me into the kingdom of his what? Dear son. He has already what? Done.
Yes.
You have been what? Bought with the price.
Yes.
So you can glorify God in your body and in your soul because you belong to God.
Yes.
Amen. And Satan has no right to what? Lord it over you because what? You are a child of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. How many can say amen?
Amen.
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 Like, is God's word reliable?
Yes.
Hallelujah. If God says you've been redeemed from the curse of the law, have you been redeemed?
Yes.
If God says, hallelujah, he's delivered you from Satan's, amen, dominion, amen, have you been delivered?
Yes.
If you've been delivered, I want you to stand on your feet and say, I've been delivered. I've been delivered. Stand on your feet and say, what God said about me is true. That I can do all things through Christ. Come on, say, greater is he that is in me. I'm standing on the foundation of God. The foundation of God is sure. Heaven is sealed. Heaven is sealed. He knows them that are his. And we overcome him. Satan, the world, sin, sickness, our circumstances. We overcome because he said we overcome. By the blood of the Lamb. Say it again, by the blood of the Lamb. Say it again, by the blood of the Lamb. And the word of my testimony. I have what I have. If God says I have. Do all things through Christ that strengthens me. The word is my said. Come on, lift your hands and give him praise. Lord, I thank you. Come on, tell him, I thank you, Lord. Come on, lift your hands and Lord, I thank you. Come on, lift your hands and Lord, I thank you. Because you have sent your word. And you have healed me. And you have delivered me out of all of my distresses. Lord, I thank you for the word. It is a living thing.